Hi, I'm Erin Bassett, and today I'm going to share with you how I created my own DIY ugly holiday sweatshirt. Now I got started in a photo editing program, and I used that to create this word art that I'm going to use on my sweatshirt. I just typed in the words that I needed and saved it as a JPEG file. That way I can trace it in Scan and Cut Canvas. Now when I open up Scan and Cut Canvas, I pick a new project, and then I'm going to that image tracing, choosing my file, and then clicking on color and OK. So you can see it traced my words exactly how I created them, and now I'm going to select the extra little centers of these letters and hit delete on my keyboard to get rid of them. Now to group them, I'm just going to select all the words and exclamation points and then right click, or you can go up to edit and click group, and then you'll be able to move them anywhere on your mat. Now if you're going to save this to your computer, go ahead and name it, and then you can click to save it to your computer. And I'm going to just transfer it over to my Scan and Cut so I can use it right away. Be sure to measure on your shirt how much space you have for each of the design elements. So next, I'm going to apply the white flocked heat transfer vinyl onto my cutting mat. And for this project, it doesn't matter if I end up cutting through that shiny protective cover because my font is really thick and I've welded some of my letters together. However, if you're cutting out individual letters, you definitely want to flip your vinyl over so that you're cutting just through that and not through that protective cover that's going to help you transfer those letters onto your garment. Since our wireless transfer was complete, we can just click on the retrieving button and voila, there it is on our screen. So the mat's loaded into the machine and now I'm going to add a test cut. So I'm going to pick that triangle and set. And I'm just going to move it underneath my words so it's just easier to access. I'll click OK, OK, and cut. And now when it cuts, it's going to cut out that little triangle first, and then it'll pause so I can see how well it did. And once your test cut is successful, you can go ahead and hit start and it'll continue cutting. When the cutting has stopped, hit unload and then the home button. For the gingerbread men, we're going to use the built-in patterns. So click on those and it'll be under that holiday one. And you can see there's our little gingerbread man. So adjust the size as you need it and then hit OK. And then we want to choose that A pattern. It's just the outline of him, not all of his features and buttons and everything. And then we'll click OK. And we just need one, so we're going to set it onto our mat. And then since we're cutting a different material, we want to add a test cut. So you're going to go up to add and then back to patterns and add that test cut. And again, once your test cut is successful, go ahead and finish cutting it out. Let's finish cutting. I'm just going to remove that extra fabric that's on there and leave the gingerbread man in place. You can see he cut out really well. And now I'll go into patterns and those border patterns, and I'm going to go up a page to get that zigzag. And I'll set that onto my mat. And now I am going to scan my gingerbread man in so I can place my zigzag exactly where it needs to be. Now I want the zigzag going diagonally across his body, so I'm going to click that mat icon and then our sizing options, and you can see right here is the rotate buttons, and so you can choose which degree of rotation you need. And once that's in place, hit OK, OK, and you can zoom in to help you with placement, and then just click OK. And you'll just OK your way out to that cut screen and hit cut and start. And And so here he is. I just want to show you his little cut zigzag. And then I'm going to take this off of my mat and load on that remnant of fabric so I can scan in some more men. So there's my remnant, and now I can just move these little guys exactly where I want to and use up all those scraps. So once all my pieces are cut out, I can put them onto my sweatshirt and then cover them with a pressing cloth and iron them. And then I got some trim and buttons out to embellish, but first I want to make sure I peel off that protective cover that, remember, I cut through, and I'm just going to gently pull it right off. And then when I embellished, I just used fabric glue to adhere everything together. For more information about Scan and Cut, go to scanandcut.com. And for more ideas and inspiration, visit erinbassett.com.